Hello and welcome to Money Control. This is Shraddha Sharma and you're watching Editor's Take. CG Power Industrial Solutions Limited has disclosed major accounting irregularities and governance lapses. While the company is under scrutiny, let's get more details on that with Money Control's Prince Thomas. Hi and welcome to the show, Prince.
Hi, Shraddha.
So if we talk about at the corporate governance level, what are the issues with CG Power?
Quite a few, actually. Interestingly, the whole thing started with a failure to pay interest. And this was brought to the notice of the company. And interestingly, they couldn't actually trace the obligation. And this forced the company to do investigations, and which unearthed unauthorized transactions by employees. These were related, unrelated, and all of these transactions were understated. Even the liabilities at the company and group level were understated, and we're talking about 4,000 crore around that figure of total liabilities that were understated.
Okay, so we talked about employees. Do we have any names of these employees that we are talking about?
The company hasn't named them as yet, but it does say that some of the key management personnel and even directors could be involved in this, but it has refrained from naming them as of now. Avanta Group is still listed as the promoter. Some time ago, it had pledged all its shares to the lenders, but it's still listed as the promoter. And Gautam Thapar is the non-executive chairman, and he chairs the board right now.
So after the disclosure, the company's shares have been in the red. But why are the shares of Yes Bank falling?
Yeah, so as the promoters had pledged, some of the lenders invoked the pledged shares. And Yes Bank was one of them. And because of it, it holds about 12.8% stake in CG Power. Likewise, also a lot of mutual funds who own substantial stakes. These include mutual funds of HDFC, Aditya Birla Sun Life. So that is one reason why Yes Bank shares went down, because of its exposure to CG Power.
So if you talk about the next step, what is the next step for the company and the stakeholders?
Right. Now, the company yesterday talked about working and further investigating along with auditors. It also plans to do a forensic investigation. Likewise, Business Standard also reported that the Ministry of Corporate Affairs has ordered a probe into these allegations. So as the investigations happen, we believe that the company may reveal the names of personnel involved in this. So there could be some well-known names or senior personnel. So let's see how it goes.
So we'll have to wait for the names.
That's
Thank
right.
you for the details on that, Prince.
Sure.
That's all for today's episode of Editor's Take. For more news, views and updates, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com. Thanks for watching.